Shema, Durga Devi here. I'm here to talk about the topic of the day, or of the year, or the decade, which is integrity. And I wanted to ask you what you think the meaning of integrity means to you. Like, what does it mean to you if someone has integrity? If you have integrity, how does that come across? How does that show up? For me, integrity means keeping my word, honesty, follow through, and also once you make a commitment, to keep that commitment. And this goes into respect of the other person you're making the commitment to. I'm talking about like appointments and showing up on time, and how do you show up? So if you are going to any type of an appointment in which you're sitting down with one person, it's pretty intimate, like a business meeting or, you know, a private coaching session, which I offer. If you have, let's say, a noon appointment and you show up right at noon, to me, you're late. And why? Because you show up, you're rushing in, you didn't plan, you made it, you think in the nick of time you got there, but then it's like you gotta kind of unwind and settle in and get your head in the space. So you're not really there at noon. So integrity means showing up a little bit early. Honestly, I mean, on time is okay, it's better than late. But really, to have high integrity, I would say be there 5 minutes early. That's not a big deal to be there 5 minutes early. And if the person's not quite ready for you, they're probably right about ready. I strive to be at least 5 minutes settled into the space. Everything is set. The water is waiting for you, or the tea in the fall and winter is waiting for you. I have everything I need with me for my session. I have my notebook, I have a pen, I've used the bathroom, all of those things. So it just seems to be, I'm not just saying in the yoga community, but in humanity, it seems to be a thing lately with the lack of showing up on time or showing up at all, and also how you're showing up. And then the communication aspect too. I could go on for an hour probably with that. But I do just want to say that I recently today was supposed to have a noon meeting with a professional. I don't know who this man is. I looked him up online afterwards, and he's a businessman. He wears a business suit. He's working for a nonprofit organization that's supposed to be helping small businesses. They sent me an email to sign up for a free session for some help as a small business owner and woman-owned business. And so I was like, okay, great. You know, I can set aside half an hour and book a time. And I booked everything else around it today. And I cooked lunch for Shiva Das and told him it's on the stove. I got my meeting. I wanted to be on at least 10 minutes early. So I was on 10 minutes early. I had my notebook. I reread my email they sent me. I had some questions in my mind that I wanted to ask. Noon comes, still no one signed on the other end. Like, I don't know, maybe I'm not signed in right. Let me sign in again on my phone instead of on my computer. So now I'm signed into two devices and I can tell like it's still the same, like I'm at the same place. And I waited 5 minutes, solid 5 minutes. To me, that's long enough when you have a 30 minute appointment, 5 minutes, that's all you get. So I signed off. And I sent the guy an email right away and I said, you know, I was logged in early. I waited till 12:05. No one showed up. I didn't get any communication. So I signed off and now I'm, you know, having lunch with my husband. So he writes back. I checked after lunch and says, not hello, no greeting. This is also the communication. Has just declined so much in our society. No greeting, even though I wrote Namaste, Daryl. I was on, what happened? And I signed off. So he says, no greeting. He just says, I don't know what happened. I was on, he says he was on, at 11:30 till 11:45. Now, our meeting was at noon. So why would you be on at 11:30 to 11:45 and then sign off? And then his next sentence was, I don't know what happened with our times. There must have been a mix-up. Now he's responding to an email that shows the timestamp confirmation of our meeting at noon. And he's taking no responsibility that he either didn't have the time right, totally forgot about the meeting, because I have no proof that he signed on early. There was no communication to me about it. And then says, let me make it up to you. Let me stop by today. I don't know this guy. I'm working out of my house. I don't want this guy just showing up to my house, stopping by. And what, he thinks I have all day open to listen to who knows what he's going to share with me. And I have zero confidence in this guy. So I don't even want to waste my time. So I thought about it and I wrote him back and I just said, look, I don't have the confidence in you, because you didn't take any responsibility for your error. And at this point, I don't know you and I don't want you stopping by my house. I work from home. And I said, but I do offer one-on-one coaching, focusing on integrity, which I think you would benefit from. And I said, you don't have to sign up with me, but I do recommend that you look into that if you want to continue on this, career path, because who's going to want to do business with someone like that? I don't. So I'm just going to contact somebody else at the agency. But this has been like, I don't deal with a lot of public people or business people like this. Very rare, really. And I was just like appalled. For all of my classes I teach, events I lead, coaching sessions, I'm there early and ready. What about you? How's your integrity? And what does integrity mean for you? I'd love to hear from you. Jane.
It needs you some integrity.